Let us study rationalization method. Rationalization method. What the method says कि जब हमारे पास ऐसे लिमिट्स फाइंड करने के लिए होंगे जिसमें अंडर रूट मींस स्क्वायर रूट इन्वॉल्व हो, सो इन दैट केस व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू रैशनलाइज वेदर इट इज द न्यूमरेटर वन और द डिनोमिनेटर वन, वी हैव टू रैशनलाइज दैट वन एंड फर्दर प्रोसीड. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट बाय टेकिंग एन एग्जांपल. लिमिट एक्स tends to 0 under root 2 plus x minus under root 2 upon x. What do you have to do? You have to find out the limit when x approaches 0. Now, first thing we have to do is we have to substitute the value of x in the function. And when we substitute the value of x in the given function, what we get as a result is 2 plus 0 square root of 2, that will give square root of 2 minus square root of 2, which is 0. Now in the denominator it will be directly 0, so it's in the form 0 by 0. So here what you have to do, as per the method says whenever we see our square root function that is here in the numerator, what you have to do, you have to rationalize that. To rationalize a certain under root factor, we have to multiply that factor into the rationalizing factor of that function. So the rationalizing factor here is under root 2 plus x plus under root 2. So why it is the rationalizing factor of the number? Since this is the number, this is the function that makes the original one, that is under root 2 plus x minus under root 2, to a rational number. Means agar hum in dono ko multiply karte hain, that will lead to a rational number. That's why the second one is called the rationalizing factor of the first one. And we have to write the function and we have to take the limit as well. Now the numerator becomes, which is a minus b multiplied by a plus b, will give us to a square minus b square, that is under root 2 plus x the square minus under root 2 the square whole upon x. And one more thing we have to do, we got the rational number by multiplying this one, but originally we didn't have this number in our question, so we have multiplied that number. What do we have to do? We have to divide that number as well to normalize the equation. So here also we have to multiply that number. Now take the limit when x tends to 0. Now the numerator becomes under root 2 plus x the square minus under root 2 the square, that will be 2 plus x minus 2 equal to x. So we can write the numerator as x, and we already have a x in the denominator, so both of them will get cancelled and limit x approaches 0. Now when we substitute the value of x in the given function here, so what we get? We get under root 2 plus 0 plus under root 2, that is 2 root 2. So in the denominator we get 2 root 2. So the final one will be limit x tends to 0 under root 2 plus x minus under root 2 upon ax is equal to 1 upon 2 root 2, which is our final answer. Thank you. Let us understand this method of rationalization by taking one more example. As we have already learned, okay, whenever we see a square root factor, so the first thing that should come to our mind is to rationalize that factor. Here we have to find the limit of under root x multiplied by under root x plus c minus under root x. Here there are two square root factor, one is under root x and the other one is this one, under root x plus c minus under root x. So in this case we have the dual mind whether we go for go to rationalize the first one or to rationalize the second one. So first one, we don't have to much, we don't have to worry that much about this function. What we have to do is the keep aside this function and we should rationalize the second one, which is under root x plus c minus under root x. So the rationalizing factor of this one that we have already know is this one, under root x plus c minus under root x. So we have to keep it plus here. So finally this will be multiplied and give us the result as under root x plus c the square minus under root x the square. So since we have multiplied the rationalizing factor and we in the question originally we didn't have this, so what do you have to do? We have to divide that factor as well. Okay, now in the numerator what we left, under root x plus c minus under root x multiplied by under root x plus c plus under root x, these two factors give us x plus c the under root the square minus under root x the square upon under root x plus c my plus under root x when limit x approaches infinity. Now this one, this factor becomes x plus c minus x and the denominator will be as before when limit x approaches infinity. Now here we can cancel out x and x, so what is left there, limit x tends to infinity c multiplied by under root x upon under root x plus c plus under root x. Now when we substitute infinity here, what do we have? We have a infinite upon infinite form, that is infinity upon infinity form, which is also an indeterminate form. So to eradicate that one, what we'll do, we'll divide under root x in both numerator and denominator. So while dividing under root x from numerator, we will have c as the result, and while dividing, let us keep it like that. Limit x tends to infinity c upon under root x upon x, this one, plus under root x upon x. Now this will become limit x tends to infinity c upon 1 plus c upon x plus 1. So when again when we substitute the value of x in the function, we'll have c upon 1 plus c upon infinity the square root plus 1, that will give us c plus 1 c upon 1 plus 0 the square root plus 1, which is c upon 2. So the final answer is c upon 2, which is the limit of the given function. Thank you.